The Apostle Paul told people the good news about Jesus wherever he went. When he returned to Jerusalem, the believers were glad to see him. But many Jews did not like that Paul taught people they don't have to follow Jewish laws to be saved. So these Jews made a plan to stop Paul. Paul was at the temple when a crowd of people dragged him away and tried to kill him. But a Roman official came and stopped them. The official arrested Paul and brought him to the Sanhedrin, a powerful group of Jewish priests and other leaders. Their job was to decide if a person had broken a Jewish law, and if so, to decide how that person should be punished. Paul stood in front of the Sanhedrin and looked the men in the eyes. "Friends," he said, "I have done what God wants me to do. I do not believe I have done anything wrong." Paul explained that he had been arrested because he taught that Jesus' resurrection gave hope that we all can be resurrected. The men in the Sanhedrin began arguing. Some of them thought dead people would be resurrected at the end of time, and others thought that would not happen. The Roman soldiers took Paul away to keep him safe. The next night, the Lord stood by Paul and gave him an incredible message. "Have courage," he said. "You told about me in Jerusalem. I want you to tell about me in Rome too." In the morning, a group of Jews got together and made a plan to kill Paul. They promised to not eat or drink until Paul was dead. These men told the Jewish leaders about their plan. Paul's nephew overheard this evil plan. He hurried to tell Paul what was going on. Paul told his nephew to report it to the commander. The army commander said, "Don't tell anyone that you told me about this plan." Then the commander told two of his officers to get together a large group of soldiers and horses. They brought a horse for Paul to ride on. And that night, the soldiers took Paul to Caesarea to see the governor. Even when others threatened his life, Paul continued to obey Jesus. He believed that God, who showed his love for the world by sending his son to die on the cross and rise again, would help him through hard times. We too can risk everything to share the gospel with courage because we know that God loves us and will care for us.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Jace from West Frankfort, Illinois asks,
"Why do some people want others to stop sharing good news about Jesus?"
Jace, that is a fantastic question. You know, we see this in the Bible story today when some people wanted to stop Paul from telling others about Jesus. We've also seen it earlier. People did the same thing. They tried to keep Peter quiet. Even in the Gospels, people tried to stop Jesus himself from sharing how we can be saved and know God personally. So why? Why did people do it then? Why do people do it now? So at the core here, what I think is going on is that people, when they're confronted by Jesus, it forces them to look within themselves and realize that they are not following him. They've not trusted in him. And that really makes them uncomfortable. And I think when they're confronted with the truth, and God is true, and they're confronted with that truth, the way they defend themselves because they're not ready to follow Jesus is they push back against him. And so it's really a defense mechanism on a lot of people's thought. I think that is really at the core of what is going on here. And so when people push back and they try to keep us quiet from telling others about Jesus, I don't think we should see them as enemies, as hostile toward us. I think we should see them with sympathy, with compassion, with love, because they're missing it. They're missing the truth. They've not trusted in Jesus, and they desperately need to hear about God and about how they can be saved through Jesus so they can come to know him. So to me, I think when we respond in situations like this, it should be through that, with compassion and with a heart to care about that person who's trying to keep us quiet. So here's a question back for you. How could you respond to someone who doesn't want to hear what you have to say about Jesus?
been given a gift from above, a message to tell of God's great love. We must go now. We have been sent out. This is where the mission begins. Filled with God's power, His Spirit now within us. This is where the mission begins. To tell about Jesus, we'll go to the ends of the world. This is where the mission begins. Jesus, we go where He leads. We are His people and He is our King. We are one body, we are the church, and we'll share the gospel throughout the earth. We will go now. We have been sent out. This is where the mission begins. Filled with God's power, Spirit now within us. This is where the mission begins. To tell about Jesus, we'll go to the ends of the world. This is where the mission begins. Can stop us, our God is with us, boldly we proclaim. Salvation has come to those who call on Jesus' name. Nothing can stop us, our God is with us, boldly we proclaim. Salvation has come to those who call on Jesus' name. God's power, His Spirit now within us. This is where the mission begins. To tell about Jesus, we'll go to the ends of the world. This is where the mission begins.